Welcome to Everyday Cooking. Today we are going to see lemon rasam without rasam powder and tamarind. For this, take 1/4 cup of split pigeon peas, that is toor dal. Clean it with water and add 1 cup of water. Close this and cook for 4 to 5 whistles. We are not going to use the ready-made rasam powder, so we are going to prepare it. Take 1/2 teaspoon of coriander seeds, 1 teaspoon of peppercorns, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds. Dry roast them. To this, add few curry leaves and 3 to 4 garlic cloves. Roast this well. Dry roast this for 1 or 2 minutes. You'll get a nice aroma, and that time you can switch off the flame. This is ready. You can see that everything got roasted well. Once it cools down, you can transfer this into a mixie jar and grind this coarsely. So we have done with our rasam masala. Take this and set this aside. Now chop a tomato, add it into the mixie jar and grind it into a fine paste. This is ready. Let us transfer this into another bowl. The next item we need is lemon. So we are going to take juice out of 1/2 lemon. By the time, we'll check whether our dal is ready. So here the dal is also ready. It is cooked perfectly. Now we'll move on to the main tempering. Pour some oil in a pan. To this, add 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds and 1/2 teaspoon of split black gram, that is urud dal. Let the mustard pop. Once it starts popping, you can add few curry leaves and the grinded masala. Saute this well for about a minute or two. Once this is sauteed well, you can add 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder and 1/4 teaspoon of asafoetida, that is hing. And for the spiciness, you can add around 1 or 2 dry chilies. Saute this for about a minute and then add the grinded tomato. Give this a nice saute. You can saute this until the oil oozes out. If you can see some oil oozing out here and there, you can add the cooked dal. To this, add the required amount of salt. I'm using rock salt. You can use either the rock salt or the powdered one. This is rasam or soup, so you have to add enough water to make it little watery. According to the consistency, you can add around 1 cup of water. Bring it to a boil, and once it starts boiling, you can add the lemon juice and switch off the flame. A perfect rasam needs some flavor of coriander leaves, so add few chopped coriander leaves. Our rasam is ready. Let us transfer this into another bowl. This rasam will be a perfect combination for rice, or if you want to have it as a soup, go for it. It'll taste so good. We'll join you in another interesting recipe, and don't forget to subscribe our channel.